be seated. The one who is doing the eulogy, please go forward.
Afternoon. We're Marge and Lloyd Doyle. We're good friends of Leona and Gary's. This is my wife Marge and I'm Lloyd. Leona left me a message that I'm willing to pass on to you, plus some additional from my own comments. She was born in a family of 10. Only one brother is alive. She was raised 40 miles northeast of Edmonton, in a small farming community of Lamont, Alberta. She walked 2 miles to school in grade 1 to 4, and then she attended the Lamont school from 5 to 11. She then moved to northern town of Kanisco, but she missed her grad because of her move. She worked nights at a telephone company, then the Royal Bank, and Grand Prairie as a newspaper with the newspaper. She moved to the Okanagan with the Bank of Montreal, where she worked for 20 years, and then Alberta, and then back to Vernon. So you can see she's moved around quite a bit. She met the love of her life, Gary, in Vernon, and was married for 46 years. They have one daughter, Kira. Gary and Leona were the greatest of friends and enjoyed retirement traveling on day trips for 10 years. They would take and walk on a ferry and go to Sydney for lunch and enjoy the day and then come back, as I was telling some of you people earlier. Gary died in February 15th, 2020, which was a very sad day for Leona. She was his support, as his health deteriorated over 5 years, she had lost her best friend. Leona did home support for 15 years and volunteered senior facilities for another 15. Leona loved to sing, and anybody that knows Leona knows how she could sing. And most of it related, if you ever heard her, of a wonderful. Plus, she just sat down at the piano and she would just play. All you had to do was hum the tune and she could play it. She didn't need music, she didn't need anything. She was marvelous. What a gift she had that we all enjoyed. She used to go to Laurel Place and different places with us for church services and for the care and the seniors. And that's all she had to do, was just sit at the piano and play. Her family grew up in a very musical family. Taking pictures of flowers was another one of her great gifts. And I don't know if you, but we received many gifts of pictures of flowers that she would take, and she'd get up close and she'd take a beautiful picture and send it to us. She loved to do jigsaw puzzles, which was always, she enjoyed, even if it was challenging. When they moved out of their house, which was very close to us, they moved to 80th and 120th on the 9th floor over here. They nicknamed it Cloud 9 because it was the 9th floor, and they loved where they lived, calling it the beauty of God's creation, as she referred to it, as beautiful beyond words and imagination, because she could look out towards the ocean, she could look north towards the mountains, and it really was a beautiful place at that. Now, I would like to share some words that Leona wrote for us, for me to share with you people. I would like to thank all my family, loved ones and friends, for the support she received when and her loving and best friend Gary died in February 20. Most of all, she'd like to thank everyone for the support and compassion, love during the time when she was diagnosed with cancer. Joseph was so helpful to her, and I want to thank him for all he did for me. Your love was truly grateful. During this challenging time, I was filled with fear, loneliness, and a very sad heart. It was just 6 months after Gary died, October the 12th, which would have been our 46th anniversary. She often talked to us on the phone for hours. We laughed, we cried for all that was going on through her life. If you know Leona, you would know how special her laugh was. It was infectious. It was these memories that helped her carry on knowing that God was in control of her life. Leona felt truly blessed with all the beautiful gifts she received through the intercessions of our Blessed Mother, the unconditional love of Jesus and the Holy Spirit. The daily masses and prayers kept her spiritual life and her heart filled with love. Leona hopes her loving heart will remain with us forever. She says, God bless you and keep you safe in his loving arms. Amen.
Thank you so much. Please rise. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good afternoon. So we are here to celebrate this Mass for souls of Leona and Gary Sidone. When they were married, I think they came together in the church, probably for sitting in the same kind of place, and now that they had been together for a number of years, one left early, and then finally Leona joined her husband in heaven, and now they are together again in this church, and we celebrate this Mass on their behalf, asking the Lord to receive them and give them eternal rest. So, brothers, to prepare ourselves to celebrate this Holy Eucharist, let us call to mind our sins and ask God for pardon. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, whose nature is always to forgive and to show mercy, we humbly implore you for your servants, Leona and Gary, whom you have called to journey to you, And since they hoped and believed in you, grant that they be led to our true homeland to delight in its everlasting joys. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. And the first reader, please go forward to read the first reading.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food, and he will destroy on this mountain the shroud cast over all people, the sheet spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever. Then the Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces, and the disgrace of his people he will take away from all the earth. For the Lord has spoken. It will be said on this day, see, this is our God. We have waited for him so that he might save us. This is the Lord for whom we have waited. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation. The word of the Lord.
Prepared a banquet.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. None of us lives for oneself, and none of us dies for oneself. For if we live, we live for the Lord, and if we die, we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. For we shall all stand before the judgment of the seat of God, for it is written, as I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bend before me, and every tongue shall give praise to God. So then each of us shall give an account of himself to God. The word of the Lord.
Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Standing by the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved, that is John, standing beside her, he said to his mother, "Woman, here is your son." Then he said to the disciple, "Here is your mother." And from that hour, the disciple took her into his own home. The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. Dear brothers and sisters and friends, we are here this afternoon to celebrate this funeral mass for Leona and also for her husband, Gary. Happy the flower which on appearing above the ground is greeted by warm sunshine. That flower feels welcomed. It feels embraced. Therefore, it is able to grow. Love is to a child what sunshine is to a flower. The experience of being loved as a child gives us a feeling that we belong on this earth. It gives us warm feeling about life. But above all, it gives us a good feeling about ourselves. It gives us a sense of our own worth without a sense of our own worth. We will always be empty inside. God entrusted the great task of giving us this love, not to two superhuman beings, but to two limited human beings, namely our parents. It was from them that we got our first and most important experience of love. Parents don't have to be clever or talented or rich. All they need is a warm heart. While both parents have a role to play on this, the role of the mother is very special. We will never again be as close to anyone as we were to our mother when we were little. In most countries, I'm from Africa, but even here, when we cried by the name of the mother. Mama, 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 oh mom, mom, when we scream. Few of them, they do dad, dad, not so many. So we'll never again be as dependent on anyone as we were on her. She literally was our lifeline. Under God, we owe practically everything we are to her. Today, we are celebrating this month to someone whom the role of motherhood was very important. That is Leona. Leona was a mother and wife. She was married to Gary and lived for 46 years. Her husband died on February 15 of year 2020, I still remember. It was a very sad day for Leona, who supported and helped him during his deteriorating battle for 5 years, together forever, in goodness, in sickness, in health, they were together. So this was a very big adjustment for her as she lost her love and best friend. She worked for home support and volunteered at seniors' facilities, I'm told you, like about 15 years. She loved singing and play the piano. Taking pictures was always a joy for her, especially flowers. I think that's why you have also good flowers for her today. Even through a mother's love is the most reliable love that we have. It is still human and as such is imperfect and limited. We all long for a love that is absolutely trustworthy. Only God can give us what we are looking for. A mother's love reminds us of God's love and is a reflection of it. The Bible uses it as an image of God's love. Can a woman forget her nursing child or show no compassion for the child of her womb? Even this may forget, yet I will not forget you. See, I have inscribed you on the palms of my hands. At no time do we so need to be reminded of God's love as at death. At death, everything is out of our hands. Everything is out of our control. We are on our own. But there is one who is still there for us. God, having loved us into existence and all through our lives, does not abandon us in death. From the gospel we heard how a mother's love endures to the end. Leona kept her faith to the end. She belonged to this Catholic church, and before she died was able to receive the sacraments of confession, anointing of the sick, and Holy Communion. The last time I visited her at Sare Memorial Hospital was on May 3rd, and she was very happy to see me. She recognized me, we shared lots of stories, and she was very happy to relayed to me that I have already confessed, I was anointed, and I received Holy Communion. So I gave her another blessing. She was well prepared for her final days here on earth. God's love enables us to cast off from this earth and set sail for the other world, buoyed up with hope. Many thanks to all special people who cared for her so lovingly. Some of you successfully met the delicate and challenging task of leading Leona to deal with realities that were not always easy to accept. May this sacrifice of mass be our consolation and hope that then one day we'll meet Leona and Gary again in heaven. We are born in exile and we die there too. When we die, we do not so much go to God as return to him. Let us continue to pray for Leona and Gary together for life, to pray for their family and friends and each other. May they rest in peace. Amen. Will you please rise? God has called us, has called some of us to meet him in death. Let us pray that we too will always be ready to welcome the Lord when he comes. After each prayer, our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. Father in heaven, deepen the faith of your church in resurrection and eternal life, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Have mercy on Leona and Gary Sidon, and grant them everlasting joy in your heaven, we pray to the Lord. Look with mercy on their family and friends, and help us to bear the burden of sorrow. In the spirit of faith, we pray to the Lord. Teach us all to live our daily lives in your love, so that we will always be ready when you call us to judgment, we pray to the Lord. Grant that we who gather here today will one day be together again in the kingdom of heaven, we pray to the Lord. As we lament the departure of our sister Leona and also her husband Sidon, Gary Sidon, from this life, grant, O Lord, that we may remember that we are most certainly to follow them. Give us grace to make ready for our last hour by a devout and holy life, and protect us against a sudden and unprovided death. Teach us how to watch and pray, that when your summons comes, we may go forth to meet Christ and enter everlasting life. We ask this in the name of Jesus the Lord. Amen. Please be seated. Please rise. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servants, Leona and Gary, we beseech your mercy that they who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. And with your spirit, lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, in him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life with change did not end it. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness, make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Yeah. Therefore, as we celebrate the memory of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have heard us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servants, Leona and Gary Sidon, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that they who are united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, all we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Please stand. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. For communion, only the Catholics who are well disposed will come forward and receive the Lord in the communion. And if you just want to come for a blessing, please indicate by putting your arms on your chest and I will give you a blessing. But don't receive the Eucharist if you are not a Catholic and if you are not well disposed for it. Thank you.
Friend, let me
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Gary and sister Leona may come to the eternal table of Christ, who reigns forever, and who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Trusting God, we have prayed together for Gary and Leona, and we now come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Leona and Gary again and enjoy their friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another. You can do the song of farewell. In baptism, Gary and Leona shared in the death and resurrection of Christ. May they be welcomed into the glory of eternal life. Can sing the song of farewell. Faithful God, my dear friends, as we prepare now to take away the remains of our brother and sister, we recall that our bodies will bear the imprint of the first creation when they were fashioned from dust. But in faith we remember too that by the new creation we also bear the image of Jesus, who was raised to glory. Let us pray in confident hope that one day God will raise us up and transform our mortal bodies. Faithful Lord of all creation, you desire that nothing redeemed by your Son will ever be lost, and that the just will be raised up on the last day. Comfort us today with the word of your promise, as we will be returning our ashes of our brother Jerry and our sister Leona to the earth. Grant a place of rest and peace where the world of dust and ashes had no dominion. Confirm in our hope that they will be created anew on the day when you raise them up in glory to live with you and all the saints. So I would like to take this opportunity to really thank our altar server who showed up for this Mass, for the choir, thank you for the nice music, for the readers, you did a good job by readings. No, you were very peaceful, the one who gave the eulogy, the family and friends, and all of you for this celebration. It's very meaningful for all of us. They are not gone. They are still with us, in our minds, in our memories. So let us keep praying that one day the Lord will gather us together again. So thank you so much, and thank you for bringing the ashes, and also for all of you who attended this Mass. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. This Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love God and serve others. Thanks be to God. So, me and the altar server will lead you down in procession as we go out with the ashes of our brother Gary and also our sister Leona.